Hi, I'm Mary Ellen, and welcome to Video Wednesday, when the Southport Historical Society showcases one of our vintage historical markers. These markers were replaced many years ago and were put in storage. We've cleaned them up and will be auctioning them online beginning 31 May through June 24th. Join us on our Facebook page every Wednesday until then and enjoy our videos of these vintage historical markers. Our vintage historical marker today is a testament to the history and important work of the Cape Fear River pilots. This marker recognizes a significant structure of their trade, the pilot's tower. Prior to the 1940s, an 80-foot-high wooden structure stood at the foot of Half Street. Pilots would climb the tower and spot incoming ships. In the 1940s, the tower was replaced with a steel tower adjacent to the elevated two-story wooden building, which is on the current site. By the end of the 20th century, the top part was removed as a modern communication system made the tower obsolete. I'm happy once again to introduce current Cape River pilot, Tommy Brendle. Captain Brendle is a fifth-generation river pilot. We can always depend on him to keep the history of river pilots alive. We appreciate his efforts and time he contributes in doing so, along with his significant duties while serving as a river pilot. Captain Tommy never tires of explaining the details of their work, both past and present. While climbing the tower to spot ships is no longer necessary, climbing up the Jacob's ladder onto the ships is still required. Their work remains hazardous and requires minute attention to detail and dedication to duty. Please join me and let's go to the riverfront and enjoy the view and Captain Tommy's presentation. I present Captain Tommy Brendle.
For over 250 years, Southport's river pilots have looked for and spotted ocean-going vessels approaching the Cape Fear River entrance. These vessels all having intentions of making a port call. Our pilots have loaded up in their small boats, met these vessels in the ocean and boarded by rope ladder, and then guided them through the river while avoiding the shallows. As you can imagine, prior to the 1950s and mostly unavailable and unreliable radios or ship-to-shore communications, an elevated viewing platform for spotting their next customer was vital to the pilots. Even Baldhead Island got its name from the use of a large hill or dune on that beach where pilots would climb that hill to be able to spot ships farther offshore. And the dune was used so much that the foot traffic of the pilots kept the vegetation worn to a minimum, therefore it resembling a bald head. Now also back in those days, if a vessel was not fortunate enough to be spotted by a local pilot, they would often fire a gun or a cannon to signal their need for a local pilot. There were at least two towers like this one located 200 foot to the east of here at the foot of Howe Street. The latter of those two was built in 1915 following a fire that damaged the previous. After the hurricane of 1944, this tower replaced the 1915 tower. So this tower originally had only one room. It was duly used for dispatch and a bunking area. In 1976, the lower story was added for administrative office space and additional bunk space. More recently, modern communications have made a high viewing platform obsolete. So in March of 99, this tower was reduced from 90 feet to 50 feet, primarily to minimize liability from storm or hurricane and just general maintenance. Don't tell them I told you so, but if you ask any of our members who are responsible for decorating for Christmas, they would tell you it was to reduce that task by at least half. So today, our facility continues to serve as an administrative office, dispatch office, and bunk space. It also supports our communication devices and our weather station. So although there is no longer a need for high towers or a bald head, not much has changed in the last 100 years for river piloting.